got this from one of my lean brethren who I met. This guy is runs a huge company that does the installation work for Cambridge Engineering. Huge company, 100 years old. And he just was like on fire about it, one of the lead guys. And he just sent me this.
So yeah, that's pretty funny. Patrick, can you read for us?
Every morning in Africa, a gazelle wakes up. It knows it must run faster than the fastest lion or it will be killed. Every morning a lion wakes up. It knows it must outrun the slowest gazelle or it will starve to death. It doesn't matter whether you're a lion or gazelle, when the sun comes up, you'd better be running.
Okay, so that's basically an attitude. Any thoughts from the lean lens about any of that?
Go get it.
Go get her. It's a get her done. What is it? Not really in a lean environment.
Not hurrying.
Right. We're not trying to hurry and panic, but we want to keep moving at a brisk pace. Thanks.
So here's every gazelle in between the slowest gazelle and the fastest lion is good, and every lion between the slowest gazelle is all right. So you don't have to be the fastest or best, right?
Everyone knows the joke about the guys up in the Alaska with the tennis shoes. Who doesn't know that joke? Okay, who can tell the joke really well? Come on. So there's two guys and they're out in the bush, right? And the guys got, but they both got backpacks, and one guy, they see a bear and they start running, and then the guy stops and he pulls his tennis shoes out. The guy goes, "What the hell are you?" He goes, "I'm just putting on my tennis shoe." He goes, "Well, why?" He goes, "I don't need to outrun the bear, I just need to outrun you."
All right. So, Thursday, midday, that's today. Here's some humor for you. This is the struggle, right? Who feels this?
Yeah.
Oh, but I need it. Good. No, but you gotta get there fast.
Wendy's working on one of those right now.
She's doing that right now, probably.
Yeah, she's doing that right now.
All right. John, how are we looking today? Extra late? Regular late?
The plan is to work to 4:30. And if we need to, and for those who want to and are willing to, we'll do a late evening shift. If we can line the workout and it makes sense, then we'll do it.
Okay. Has John approached any of you individually on that aspect of today? One. Got it.
Everybody at the morning meeting.
Yeah.
Two.
Yeah, yeah.
Good. Yeah. I wasn't here. I was just out hanging with the brothers talking about the game. So, Saturday, looks like we have some real commitment. Thank you.
We can talk about Saturday.
You got it. Thanks.
Today, tomorrow.
Okay.
Everyone's probably feeling a little red, but when you are less red, go find somebody who's red. We're all in it together, right? Okay, we got a kind of an avalanche here. I don't want to spend too much time on exactly what it is, but you can see that the struggle we're feeling out there on the floor is translating to the struggle the poor salespeople are having to deal with. Quality at the source, right? Let's not, and not all of these could be avoided, but that which can be avoided, let's avoid it, right? And this one's not an escape, it's a turn back, but it got entered, so I can't.
Thank you.
Reconciliation.
Thanks for including that.
Easy. Shout outs.
I'll shout out everybody for the hard work and dedication.
That's a donut box or whatever.
Brad, what do you got?
Mike for humor.
Jack, what do you got, man?
2B. Pedestal broke, like I was like, shit, you know, like it's gonna be pissed, like it's a bummer. But 2 minutes later he was like laughing at Brad.
Yeah, I wanna also shout out 2P for appearing to consistently try to improve his operating system internally. And it's hard work, evolving. Enjoy the process because you're stuck with you.
Never done, right?
Yeah.
I wanted to shout out Brad for some problem solving. Didn't get to fully implement it, but it seemed to be working before everything went to heck, so I appreciate that. I wanted to shout out John for just rock steady, holding things together. I appreciate that.
First shout out to the sales office that everybody went through and contacted every customer we possibly could that didn't have a tight deadline. to buy as much time, so we adjusted the number of dates. I know I bought about 14 days, and Mike bought about 22 days. Steven, technically, yeah. Anyway, shout out to those guys. So we're definitely trying to, I think it's one of those things where we're gonna have to alleviate the burden in a number of different ways.
Yeah.
So that's one of them.
Yeah, and, basically in the timeshare business. Thanks for selling some timeshares. Is that it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool, thank you.
Shout out Seth for coming out on the floor, helping out, helping with the burden, and Lori yesterday.
Dallas,
same thing.
Dallas.
Bye. Dallas. Mm-hmm. Anyone else who can help?
Get better, get back.
All right.
Have you said all that?
Yeah. 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 Yeah